Some of you may know we did a quick survey to hear what topics interest you most in the videos. So far, the leading topics chosen were prevention and solving our breastfeeding problems. If you haven't participated yet in the survey but would like to do so, please check the link in the comment section. And meanwhile, let's get started on what up-to-date research tells us about the key factors to successful breastfeeding and avoiding most of breastfeeding problems along the way. When we look at available research around the world on the subject of breastfeeding and what is known as for what increases chances of successful breastfeeding, longer duration of breastfeeding, the level of joy the mom may receive from breastfeeding experience, we would see that three factors are being repeated over and over again. Number one is prenatal education. How much the mom knows about breastfeeding before she gives birth. Number two is the support of her partner and the enthusiasm of the partner when it comes to breastfeeding. And number three is appropriate social and professional help when needed. So let's start with number one factor, prenatal education about breastfeeding. You may think, why would anyone need to learn about breastfeeding before birth? What is there to learn? It's either you have milk or you don't have milk, right? No, it's not. And how much the mother knows about breastfeeding very often will determine how long she will breastfeed, how much milk she will produce, how many problems she will face. Actually, the more prepared the mom is before birth to breastfeeding, the less likely she will face any challenges. And even if she does, she'll be able to overcome them faster and more effectively than mothers who didn't receive as much prenatal education. So sometimes I meet people and they tell me, well, breastfeeding is easy. You give birth, you put the child to the breast, the milk is flowing, the task is done. I wish it was that easy. You know, I myself, 13 years ago, I was thinking the same. So I learned all about pregnancy and giving birth, but I took very little time to prepare for breastfeeding. And oh gosh, how overwhelmed I was when I gave birth. I realized that I didn't know how soon to start breastfeeding or how to position the child and is it normal to have sore nipples. And it was so difficult to learn it all after birth when you have your little baby in your arms. So I've done it the hard way with my first child. But I learned from my experience, and luckily now I have the chance to share with you what prenatal education can do for you and from how many troubles it can save you. So in prenatal education, there are 10 key aspects that you will cover that will help you succeed in breastfeeding. Number one, it will help you have realistic expectations as for what breastfeeding will be like and what would mothering require from you. So many of us would think that we will breastfeed on the clock, so many hours apart, 10 minutes per breast, it will be all easy, scheduled, we'll download that app on our phone, we'll monitor everything, and life will be beautiful. And then we get so overwhelmed when our little newborn needs us 24/7, and we realize that breastfeeding on schedule does not work. And that's why all the health organizations strongly recommend breastfeeding on demand as often as possible. And we have a couple of videos about that if you like to check it out. The second aspect that prenatal education can help us with is learning how birth interventions and the birth type can affect breastfeeding start. For example, very few of us know that receiving anesthesia during birth can make the baby sleepier after birth, which will mean that we need to wake up the baby and help the baby breastfeed more often. And if we don't do so, then the child may miss out on some feedings, receive less of our precious early milk, and this may lead to the higher risk of jaundice, hypoglycemia in baby, loss of weight in the child, and low milk production in mom. The third aspect that will be hugely emphasized by any prenatal education course in breastfeeding will be the importance of early initiation of breastfeeding, meaning how soon after birth we start breastfeeding. some of us will think that we'll give birth and then we'll take some rest and the baby will rest and then maybe we'll start breastfeeding 4 hours later next day. Well, the research is showing that the sooner we start breastfeeding, the more likely we'll have successful breastfeeding experience, we'll avoid problems with latching because the reflexes of the babies are the strongest in the early moments after birth, and the more milk we will have by the end of week one and month one. So WHO, UNICEF, La Leche League International, and all the leading health organizations around the world strongly recommend starting within moments to half an hour after birth with breastfeeding. The first hour is often referred to as the golden hour after birth. When we are able to start breastfeeding early after birth, we are able to prevent many potential problems with low milk supply, latching, and other issues, and we increase the chances of our successful breastfeeding journey. The fourth aspect that goes hand in hand with early initiation is called skin-to-skin contact. When a newborn baby, before being dressed, is put on the bare chest of the mother, so the hospital robe will be removed and the baby will be placed directly over the skin of mother's chest. Beautiful things happen when we allow this to take place. Baby's heartbeat stabilizes, body temperature, breathing, and it helps us increase the chances of successful breastfeeding later on for having more milk and stronger receptors for responding to the child, and of course, better reflexes from the child, because right after birth, the instincts of the baby are the strongest. So if we allow the baby to have that early skin-to-skin contact with mom, it goes a long way. And if you like to learn more about the importance of skin-to-skin contact, not only directly after birth, but also through the early days, weeks, and months after birth, you can check out multiple scientific works written on the subject, and especially you may want to check the studies of Dr. Nels Bergman. The fifth aspect is called rooming in. This is an approach when baby is kept with mom in the same room 24 hours, day and night. Rooming in is known to tremendously increase success rates in breastfeeding, and that's why it is included in the steps for baby-friendly hospitals around the world. Baby-friendly hospitals really means breastfeeding-friendly hospitals. So if you are giving birth in one of those hospitals, they already will encourage you to keep the baby with you in the same room, not separately after birth. But if your hospital doesn't have that accreditation yet, then you will need to ask for it. And attending prenatal education courses will help you be equipped with information as for why it's important and how to approach your hospital. Aspect number six is about how to position the baby at the breast so breastfeeding will be comfortable for mom. Any prenatal course on breastfeeding will cover this subject because breastfeeding is not supposed to be painful. And only when we know how to help the baby to take the breast deeply and asymmetrically into the mouth, we will be able to breastfeed comfortably. Aspect number seven, importance of breastfeeding on demand, or it's also called as responsive feeding. Breastfeeding on schedule doesn't work, and we do have several videos about it. Breastfeeding needs to be done on demand, and the more often, the better, so mom will have all the milk necessary. Prenatal courses will help you learn about that. Aspect number seven is very important too. Avoid bottles and pacifiers. Any prenatal course will cover how dangerous these objects can be when introduced to our newborn babies and why we need to avoid them as much as possible if we don't want to have problems with latching, sore nipples, bottle preference, nipple confusion, and even breast refusal sometimes. Aspect number nine is about pumping. Most prenatal breastfeeding courses will cover some information about when it is safer to start pumping and why it's recommended to avoid pumping unless necessary, at least for the first 40 days. Did you know, for example, that research shows that when mothers start pumping earlier than 40 days, they have an increased rate of stopping to breastfeed sooner. Yes, there are some situations when pumping is necessary in the early days and weeks after birth, but attending a prenatal course can help you learn the difference. When is it necessary and when it's better to be avoided to protect yourself from unneeded challenges and problems that may come with pumping. And the final key aspect I like to mention is about how to know if baby is having enough milk. Every prenatal breastfeeding course will give you information about it. So you wouldn't need to worry if baby is having enough, because it's not about how much the baby is crying or how much the baby is sleeping between feedings. We have other simple markers to follow on that. So this will give you confidence and protect you from falling into unnecessary problems of bottle introduction, pumping, or supplementation, which all inevitably may lead to the decrease of milk production. So look around, see what options you have, dear friends, and make sure you learn about breastfeeding before birth. Maybe you can get in touch with a breastfeeding professional for a one-on-one session, maybe group seminar, or attend an online course. And if you like to get in touch with me, please write in the comment section. I would love to be of support to you. As an IBCLC, I also give one-on-one sessions, group seminars, and I have my own online pre-recorded course for pregnant couples that is over 5 hours long. It's practical, in-depth, and it covers all the aspects of how to succeed in breastfeeding. I look forward to hearing from you.